Welcome, my dear students. Today we are going to be learning chapter 11, that is functions. So this is also a very very important topic. Let me see what is a function. Already we are familiar with functions. This question is asked. A function is a self-containing subpart of a program. It is a part of a program, and by using this part of a program, you are solving a well-defined task. Okay, so you can able to solve a well-defined portion of your program by using functions, and your C program is consist at least one function. That one function is your main function. Okay, now let us see. It plays an important role in C program development. These functions play a prominent role in your C programming development. Dividing a program into function is one of the major principle of top-down structure program. So if you observe, what is the dividing? We are dividing a program into function. Suppose if you are writing a software programs, whenever you are writing a software programs, your programs are having very complex codes. Then if you want to simplification of that complex code, then you are dividing a portion into a function, complexity into dividing. Okay, and you are dividing into a part, and you are doing that part as a function. Whenever it is necessary, you will call. Okay, let us assume in general also we are having so many problems, right? Suppose in your house, if you are celebrating any of a function, if you all, your father, mother, your brother, your sisters, all are required to involve in that celebrations, okay? If all are required to do that celebrations, and everyone has to play an important role, right? Someone has to do some house cleaning, someone has to do some catering work, someone has to do some purchasing of goods, right? If only one, your mother is only the one she is doing, then she will be get tired of immediately, right? So that is why you have to supposed to help and reduce the complexity. Okay, so to reduce the complexity of a simple, this is a general example only for your understanding purpose. Okay, so in the same sense, whenever we are developing one software programs, then software programs is also consist of a complexity. Then that complexity can be divided into a part, and that part can be called a functions. I can make the usage of that part any number of times in my program. Okay, so likewise, dividing a program into function is one of the major principle of top-down structured programming. Your C is a top-down structured programming language, and these functions play an important role. Now let us see what are the advantages of functions. If you are using the functions, it is easy to write a correct simple small function. So by using this function, you can write a correct simple small function, and next, easy to read, write and debug a function. Easy to read. Read means you can access, write means to store, and debug means correct. Okay, you can easy to write a simple small function, and easy to access, easy to correct, easy to store. All these are the possible by using function. And next one is easier to maintain or modify a function. So these functions are easy to maintain as well as modify a function. Okay, so it is easy to maintain and modify any function. Small functions are highly readable. If you are using these small functions, then it is highly readable. Readable means it is a trusty, it can work. Okay, and now it can be called any number of times in different place with any parameter. If you are using these functions, you can call any number of times that functions, okay, in different places with any parameters. So here one technical word is coming. These parameters are nothing but variables. This parameter means variables. Okay, we will see what is that parameter. Okay, so 2 marks, a very very important question. It has asked in some of a previous question paper. Now we will see the definition of a function. So already we are familiar, a function is a self-containing subpart of a program which is used to perform well-defined task. So it is a part of a program. In that part of a program, you are by using that program, it is a part of a program, but by using that part of a program, you will solve a well-defined task. Okay, you will define a well-defined task. Okay, a C program consists of one or more function. Maybe in your C program it may consist of one or more functions. Okay, if a program has only one function, then it must be the main function. In your C program, you can able to define more than one function is also possible. If your program is consist of only one function means, then it is main function. In general, how the functions can be represented? In the general, function can be represented in the form of two parentheses. So we are using these two brackets, right? This two bracket is said as functions. For example, if you see in your program, you are having void main function, printf function, scanf function, right? strupr functions, some of the built-in function, and some of the user-defined functions. We will learn step by step, and they have to give more attention on this chapter. Okay, so this is a very very important chapter where you are going to be learning a lot of things related to your C programming. Yes. So these parentheses are nothing but na brackets. Okay. Yes. With zero or more argument, it may be with zero. It doesn't consist of any argument or more argument. It may consist of number of argument, number of variables. We will see what is that arguments. Okay. Now we will come. The next topic is C program has two types of functions. Your C program consists of two types of functions. That is, one is a library function and second one is user defined function. One is a library function and another one is user defined function. Okay. Yes. Now we will see what is a library function, what is a user defined function. Now first one is a library function. C has the facility to provide some library function to the programmer for doing some operation. In chapter 3 we have learned mathematical function, that is one of a library function. Just now we have learned string handling functions, right? strupr, strlwr, strrev, strcpy, strcat, right? So these are the string handling functions. All these are the library functions. So by using that library function, you can perform the task related to that function itself only. Okay, so here suggesting as for mathematical function sqrt. What is the purpose of sqrt function? Square root of a number. What is the power function? You can use the power of base and as well as exponent, right? Got it. And absolute function, if you pass the negative value, it will show positive value. So if you want to make the usage of sqrt, power function, and absolute function in your program, you have to add math.h header file. Okay, math.h header file. If you do not add this math.h header file, your compiler doesn't understand what these are. Okay, in the same sense, string handling functions. So it has just now suggested, if you want to perform those tasks, then you have to supposed to use string.h. So these mathematical function or string handling functions are the part of your library functions. So let us see if the sample program is there, and already we have explained. Let us see here, this will perform your program. Okay, hash include stdio.h, hash include conio.h. I am using math.h function. So if you want to find the square root of a number, compulsory you have to use math.h. Now I am writing void main function. In the void main function, you are declaring two variables. See, if I copy this program, you are identifying the errors. Let us see. I am copying, and it is always better to check your program, right? Always, if you get more number of errors, then fine. If you get more number of errors, please observe, you have to study the errors. If you study the errors, you will definitely a good programmer, and you are definitely a good tester. Got it? Yes. Let me check. It program consists of errors. Let me explain the same thing. As you know, every program terminates with semicolon, right? But here I have specified colon only for understanding purpose. Here double quotation is also in wrong method. We have to study what is the errors will come. Okay, so this is a sample program related to math.h. First it is asking, please observe here percentile enter number is there, it is also error. Okay, so let me save it first. This is a sam1. I'm taking as the sample sam1.c. okay, So my program consists of error. What is the aim of a program? I want to enter a number. I want to enter a number, and that number's square root I have to identify. Okay, I have to identify the square root of that number. So to do that, let me open my editor. Yes, starting our editor. Yes, already my program consists of error. I'm using F3. What is our program name? Sam1.c. Okay, so this is the error. Already it is openly showing. Anyhow, let me compile. You are identifying 25 errors. Okay, let me press the enter. It is showing declaration terminated incorrectly. Suppose if you make it as a semicolon, even though it will show an error. Why? Because comma is there. That is why declaration terminated incorrectly. We need not have any comma after, if you don't need any variable, right? After correction of that 24 errors, illegal character. So this double quotation is illegal character. So you have to make a note. Okay, this is also illegal character, and I'm deleting. Right, yes, let me save it, and once again compile. It shows the 16 errors. Here it is showing illegal errors, right? Illegal characters. So hence we have to remove that illegal characters. Right, save it, compile it. So now it is the 9 errors. So here the illegal errors are there. Please understand this concept very carefully. And now, yes, now double quotation and save it and compile it. Now the error is 0. Okay, yes, now what is the program? You have to enter a number, but it will show garbage value. Actually in printf a percentile d is not supposed to use. Okay, if you are using percentile d, you are displaying the value. Okay, whether we are displaying the value, no, right? Please observe here, it will show garbage value. Okay, now it will show enter a number. You have to enter a number from the keyboard. I'm entering it as a 4, square root of a 4. C is equal to square root of 4. As we know, what is the purpose of square root function? To identify the square root of an entire number. Now it will give 4, means it is a 2. 2 will be stored in your C, right? Square of the number is percentile d c. If you square of a number, if you process that number, then it will give it as 2, right? So that is your program. Let me compile. There is error, no error, and please observe here, lines compiled 631. Whether 631 lines are exist? No. Got it? So all these lines are placed in your functions. Okay? Yes. Control F9. Please observe here, -28962927 is coming. It is an error because of a percentile d. Okay? Let me take 4. I am pressing the enter. Square of the number is 2, right? Yes. So why it is giving garbage value? Because while entering value from the keyboard, we need not to be display the percentile. Now save it and compile it and run it. Okay, now if you enter any number 25, what is the square root of 25? 5. Got it? So likewise, you are identifying the square root. So this is a one of a built-in function. If you want to find the square root of a number, you have to use the library function math.h. Math.h is the library function. If you use only, then square root of a function will execute. Square root of function will be executed. Okay, so likewise, this is one of a library function, and here the absolute program is there. In the absolute program, you are taking the float value, and you are entering a value. Whatever the value you are inputting in the negative, whatever the value you are inputting in the negative, okay, I'm giving it as a -5. Now if you are using the FAPS function, that negative value will be turned into positive. Okay, so if you display here the n value, it will print as positive value of a 5. Now in the same sense, if you want to find algorithms and everything, already we done these programs in your chapter 3. Once again revive it. These programs are exist, and you just revive it. So let me explain this program, even though it is there, but only for your understanding purpose, these two programs I will explain. Okay, let me take new profile and paste it. So what is the program? Base and exponent values to find the power values. Okay, power functions. Now to work, you have to suppose to include stdio.h include conio.h. void main is compulsory. Suppose if I want to perform power function, which library function we have to add? Math.h, right? Yes. Now I'm declaring three variable int a, comma b, comma c. Afterwards clear screen. Okay. Enter two numbers. Why we have to enter two numbers? We have to supply the base and power value, right? So if you want to calculate the base and here instead of two numbers, I am writing enter base and exponent value, exponent number, right? So for entering that we have to use the scanf keyboard, right? If your keyboard is works means you have to use the scanf function ampersand a ampersand b. Now you are processing c is equal to power of a comma b. For example, if I enter 2 3, so what is the 2 comma 3? 2 power 3. What is the 2 power 3 value? 8. Where it will store? In c. So after storing, it has to display the power value is 8. Got it? So the result is stored in your c and you are displaying the power value, right? And now save it. Let me make it as a pow2.c and open my editor. Alt enter. Open my file. What is the file? pow2.c, right? Yes. Now let me compile. Is there any error? No error. As you know, in the last program only I have shown you what are the errors. It will come, it will be showing one error. What is here? Undefined symbol. Please observe here, this is a linking error. This is a linking error. If you want to exit from this linking error, you have to press function key F6. Okay, function key F6. If you press the function key F6, it will go for the previous program, and in this you have to identify which is your program. This is your program, right? Yes. Let me press F5. So please observe here, we have, instead of a printf, we have taken as a pt, right? It is a printf. So that is why you have to write printf. Now compile it. Is there any error? No error. Now run it. Is there any error? No error. Now I am entering 2 and 3. Base value is 2 and exponent value is 3. 2 power 3 value is 8. Right? So whether it is 8? Yes. How we have done? C is equal to power of a comma b. C is equal to power of a comma b. 2 comma 3. Right? Yes. So likewise, this library built-in function will work. And here one more program is there. This program is a very very important program. And okay, let me copy and I will explain this program. First test it, right? So what is the program? Read the three sides of a triangle and find the area of a triangle. Okay, so we have to enter the three side of a triangle and identifies the area of a triangle. So for this, stdio.h is required, conio.h is required, and string.h, sorry, math.h, right? Hash include math.h, mathematical function, right? Now you are declaring your variable float a comma b comma c comma s. Okay, so if you enter the three sides, you have to first identify the side value and next you have to calculate the area of a triangle. Then what is the formula of area of a triangle if three sides is given? Square root of s into s minus a into s minus b into s minus c. Then how to find the side? Half into a plus b plus c. Half into a plus b plus c. So that is the formula. Okay, so this is the formula you have learned in your 10th class, right? 10th, 9th maybe, right? So we have to suppose to enter three sides of a triangle. So here float variable, right? That is why I am using percentile f. Okay, percentile f, 3% f, here double quotation comma, ampersand a, ampersand b, ampersand c. You are entering a, b, c value, you are processing s value, you are identifying the side value, and next you are calculating the area. For calculating the area, square root, right? SQRT of s into s minus e into s minus b into s minus c. So you are calculating, then you are printing the area of a circle, area of a triangle, that is area. And now you are giving getch and close, right? Let me save your file, and while saving, you have to give triangle. I'm giving triangle dot c. Now let me check what it will happen. Okay, I'm on enter f3 triangle dot c triangle dot c. No spelling mistake. What is a triangle? Okay, triangle dot c. So this is our program, right? Yes, let me compile and run. It is asking for the three side. I am giving, we have to give in the point values 10.1, 2.2, 3.3. Okay, three values, three sets angles. It is showing domain error and none. Why? a plus c by 2.0. It is always better to calculate 2.0. Now compile it. Alt F9, Control F9. Yes, 1, 2, 3. Area is 0. 1 plus 2 plus 3. What is the value? 1 plus 2 plus 3. 1 plus 2 6. 3 plus 1 plus 2 3. 3 plus 3 6. 6 by 2 3. This is a 3, right? 3 into 3 minus 1 3 minus 2 3 minus 3 0. So once 0 it comes, this is the problem will happen, right? So likewise it is 0 here f triangle. Let me enter one more value, that is 259. If I enter 259, it is giving us domain error and we do not know then why it is giving. Okay, let me run once again. Let me give 6 4 8. If you give the 6 4 8, it will give accurate values. Okay, this is error of circle, error of a triangle after entering the three sides, and you are siding the side and finding the area of a square triangle. Square root of s into s minus a into s minus b into s minus c, right? Likewise, you are entering, executing your program. Okay, so all these are the library functions. Okay, now we'll see user defined functions. Okay, so here user defined function is there. This is the second type of a function we have to use, user defined function. Okay, library function provide some specialty for doing some predefined operations. By using your library functions, you are performing some of predefined operations. So ready-made operations means it has to do that task only. The user can also create function for doing any specified task. So user can also define his own functions. Okay, why is defining his own function? To performing his own operations, his own calculations. If you want to perform special task of a program, then he can also specify his own function. Such function is called user defined function. This is very, very important. Okay, 6 months of questions are there, please make a notes. User defined function is very, very important. Let us see. Execution of every C program always begin with main function. So every execution of a C program begins with main function. After each function has done, after each function of operation like control return back to the main. If it consists more than one function, okay. So if it consists more than one function or user defined function, automatically the control will come to your main function only. Okay. So then remaining statement of the main functions are executed. After calling that user defined function, whatever the rest of the program is there, that will be executed. Here we are having three types of a function, actually four types of a function is there, but in your program, in your book, it suggests as a four function, but we are taking only three types of function. Let us see, these are the user defined function with no argument and no return value. Function doesn't consist of arguments and doesn't returns any value. So no data communication. Okay. And second type of function is function with argument but no return value. Function consists of an argument. Argument means variables, but it doesn't returns any value. Okay. And function with arguments and return value. So it is a two-way communication. Function consists of arguments and also it consists of a return value. Function consists of arguments and also it consists of a return value. Okay. So to understand this concept, what is a user defined function? Let me take this sample program. Here the sample program is exist. I have not explained here. Yes, let me copy first and I will explain now. Okay. Yes, let me take new file. This is a user defined program. Sample program on user defined function. Okay. So in user defined function, it consists of three parts. Okay. How many parts it consists? Three parts. Minimum two parts are execute. Minimum at least two parts are compulsory exist. One is a function call and another one is function body or function definition. Okay. What is the three parts consist of? First one is prototype declaration. Second one is function call. Third one is function definition. Right. In user defined function, it comprises of three parts. That three parts, one is an optional and two parts are compulsory. Which one is an optional? Prototype declaration. And function call is exist and function definition is also exist. Okay. Yes. Let us see here. Let me write first hash include stdio.h hash include conio.h. right. Afterwards I am writing one function. This is user defined function. What is the name of the function? This is the message is the name of the function. This message is the name of the function and void is the return type. Okay. So if you are declaring outside of this, this is the declaration of your function. What is this? Declaration of this function. If you are declaring the function outside of your main, if you are declaring the function, user defined function outside of the main, then it is called as function prototype declaration. What it is called? Function prototype declaration. What is a prototype declaration consist of? Return type. What is the return type? Either int, float, char, double or void. These are the return type. And what is the message? Message may be anything. Okay. Message is the name of the function. You can specify your name also. Okay. For example, in your PO college, right? In your PO college, while you are studying at your PO college, your attendance will be called by your faculty, right? Please observe this example carefully. Okay. Got it? So your faculty becomes function call. Your faculty becomes function call. One who responds for his call is function body or function definition. For example, in your class we are having, let us see some X. I will mention it is some Robin, right? If I call Robin, who will respond? Robin. So who calls Robin? Me. Who am I? Function call. Who respond for my call? Robin. Got it? Yes. Are you catching my point? So user defined function consists of minimum three parts. One is an optional part. That optional part is function prototype declaration. It may or may not exist, but two parts are definitely exist. What is that two parts? One is a function call and another one is function definition or function body. Either function definition or function body. Okay. Yes. In my example, I am the faculty. If I want to take your attendance, I am calling your name, right? Who am I? Caller. Who will respond for my call? You. So I am the function call, you are the function body. Got it? I am the function call and you are the function body. Clear? Yes. Who respond for my call? You. If you are responding means you are the function body. I am making the usage of you, right? Got it? Yes. Please make a note. here the void message is the declared. This is a declared outside of the main function. Sometimes this function prototype declaration is also possible inside of the main function. Okay, so what is the name of the function here? Message. Please observe here. Now void message function, as we know, every C program starts with main function. Now after entering here, I am calling the function. Please observe here, what is the name of the function? Message. If I call, automatically control will come here. Here the void message function definition is there. This is the function definition or body. Function definition or body is exist, right? After the body or function body, it will control will directly enter here and come here. Whatever the information we have typed, it will execute. In the printf, I am writing as simple as smile and word smile with you. So it will display. Got it? Yes. Afterwards, where the control will come? Control will come here. Printf cry. So control will return here. After the program execution, after the function call, function body will respond. After the function body execution, control will come here. Whatever the rest statement is exist here in the main function, it will be evaluate. Okay? Yes. Now I am writing here void Italy. This is also prototype declaration you have declared outside of the main, right? Outside of the main, it is a prototype declaration. What is a prototype declaration? Void Italy, void Brazil, void Argentina. Maybe it is a second program, I think so. Let me copy this first. I will cut. Let me save this first. Okay, let me see this first, what it will happen. Let me take CLRSCR. It is a simple program, don't get confused. Okay, every program starts with main function and ends at main function itself only. So whatever the function body you are writing, it must be present outside of the main function or within the main function. It may be, depends. Okay, this function body is always present outside of the main function. So here the main function will end, function body is present always outside of the main function. Okay, let me save first and give it as a fun1.c and come here and open here and press F5 and open F3 fun1.c. yes, now compile it and run it. So if you run, it will show smile and world smiles with you, cry and you stop the monotony. So to understand this concept, I am pressing how the execution will do. I am pressing F7. So if I press the F7, please observe this blinking cursor. This is our control. This is where the control will go first. It will come here main. In the main, it comes to clear screen and it calls the function call. After the calling this function call, where the control transfer, please observe here, function body. It will come to your function body. In the function body, whatever the statement is exist, it will be evaluate. After evaluation, where the control will return, please observe here carefully. It will come in your main function. Whatever the rest statement is exist, it will evaluate and afterwards only it will display. Got it? Yes. So this is your simple user defined function. Simple user defined function. Okay, let me take that another program and I'm testing here. So this is our program. Can anybody will try what we have done here? Okay, before that we have tried. This is also sample program user defined function. Okay, stdevo.h include conio.h. yes, so your main function is here. Whatever the function you are declared outside, what it is prototype declaration. Prototype declaration, and here it is also prototype declaration, right? So void Italy, void is your return type, Brazil is the name of the function. All these are the prototype declaration. Your program starts in your main function. In main function, you are writing CLR. First I am writing CLR SSR as we do not have any variable. Okay, while taking the variable program, we will see. Okay, now yes, clear screen first, it will display I am in main. Now you are calling, this is a function call, right? Italy function call, and this is your function call, correct? Yes, and this is also your function call. Okay, so I placed in a comment. If I call the Italy, automatically control will comes to your function body or function definition. So how you say it is a function body? If it consists of open and closing curly braces, then it is called as a function definition or function body. Okay, so that is why it is called as function body or definition. Okay, now in void Italy, when I am calling Italy, automatically control come here, void Italy, whatever the statement you are specified, it will be displayed. I am in Italy. After displaying this Italy, where the control will come? Control will come here. It will call the Brazil. So automatically control will come here, void Brazil. So you have to write. So you are writing this Brazil. Okay, yes, control will come here. And here after executing this, control will come your main function. In the main function, once again you are calling another function, user defined function, that is Argentina. Automatically control come here, void Argentina, and it will come here. Okay, yes, afterwards the same thing, right? It is a double time has happened. Okay, we don't need it. Let me delete. Okay, that's it. Okay, this is a sample function to program fun2. Let me save it. Fun2, I will show this program execution. So this is a prototype declaration. Don't think only the void, it consists of a int float double char also. Int float double char also. So that is your return type, your data type. Return types are nothing but data types, and whatever the name you are providing for your function is the name of the function. Okay, this is a sample program to display our values. Okay, and let me save it and come your editor and alt enter and press F3. What is the name of our function? Fun2.c, right? Yes, this is our program. Let us compile and run it. If you run, we have not get the output. Why? Because we have not specified the getch. Where we have to supposed to specify getch? In main function itself only. Okay, if you specify getch in main function only, you are getting the output. Okay, and now check it. I am in main, I am in Italy, I am in Brazil, I am in Argentina. Let me show you how it will execute. I am pressing F7. You will see the sequence. First, if I press, it will come from your main function. Already prototype declaration has been taken, and now it is coming for your clear screen. Now it display whatever the content present in printf. Now it calls for the Italy. So whenever it calls the Italy, automatically it moves to the function body, that Italy, right? So I am pressing the F7. It has entered into the Italy body, and whatever the content is displayed, it will be printed. Afterwards, it will return to the main function. In the main function, it consists of a Brazil function call. So whenever I am pressing the F7, automatically it will call the Brazil function. Body will be executed. Void Brazil body. Here it consists of a body of a statement, and it will evaluate. After evaluating, it will come to your main function. In main function, it is Argentina, and it will call the function Argentina, and it will function Argentina body will be evaluate. Okay, so after evaluating that, it will come here. Is there any other program? No. So hence it will execute the getch display your output. Got it? So likewise, your functions will evaluate. This is the user defined function. Okay, so what are the various types of what are the different types of user defined function available? First one is a function with no arguments and no written value, function with arguments but no written value, function with arguments and written value. Okay, now let me see what is a function declaration or prototype declaration. Okay, yes, if a function returns a value of data type int, then it is not necessary to declare the function. Suppose if you are using integer data type function, then you need not to specify integer data type for your user defined function. If you are operating integer type of calculations, then you need not to be specify int return type for your user defined function. Why? Because by default it returns an integer value. Okay, but if the function returns a value other than the int, but if your function will returns the value, return means it will gives a value. Okay, it will returns a value other than int, such as a float or double, then it is necessary to declare the function call. So that is why function prototype declaration is very much essential. When it is essential, if you are performing other than integer computation, integer calculations. Okay, so that is why prototype declaration is necessary. Okay, so then let us see what is the syntax of your function prototype declaration. Here return type is there, function name, data type variable 1 comma data type variable 2 comma data type variable n. So these are the parameters, or arguments. Okay, or your return type, function name, data type 1, data type 2, and so on, data type n. Data type n is exist. So likewise, you can declare function prototype declaration. For your better understanding purpose, I am taking here int add int a comma int b. So this is function prototype declaration. Okay, this is example for float sub. I'm just taking an example. Okay, float sub float x comma float y. This is the example of function prototype declaration. Likewise, double char you can specify. Okay, so you can declare outside of the main function or you can declare inside of the main function. It is no problem. Function prototype declaration may be done either outside of the main function or inside of the main function is also possible. Now our next concept is a function call. Okay, a function call is an expression. This question has asked, please go through it. It has asked for the prototype declaration function call. A function call is an expression consisting of the function name followed by the arguments enclosed in parentheses. So it is one of our expressions. Expression means one statement, one equation, one formula, right? Function call is an expression consisting. What does this expression consist of? This expression is consist of function name followed by arguments. Function name followed by arguments. Arguments in the sense, here we are seeing here float x comma float y, right? Likewise, it may exist. Okay, so enclosed in parentheses. So these brackets are treated as in a parenthesis. If there is more than one argument, if it consists more than one argument, the arguments are separated by commas. For example, you are seeing here, right? Int a comma int b. In your function call also, it may exist. If it consists these arguments, whatever the variables, please observe here, whatever the variables you are using in function call is called as argument. Whatever the variables you are using in function body is called as parameter. Got it? Whatever the variables you are using in function call is called as function argument, and whatever the variables you are using in your function definition or function body is called as parameter. Okay, yes, even though it is having some difference, we will explain it later. Okay, so let us come here function call. I hope you are understanding this function call. What is a function call? A function call is an expression consisting of the function name followed by arguments enclosed in parentheses. Okay, yes. So let us see here, a sample example is given, and I will explain this in the next class. We will continue with the function call itself only. Okay, hope you understand this concept. We will meet you in next class. I will continue what is a function call itself. Okay, yes, control